The primary goal of this tutorial is to create a simple REST API in Golang and send traces to Grafana. Let's start with a demo. Let's use curl and hit slash devices endpoint. It'll take 3 seconds for the entire request, with 2 seconds spent on the database query. Now, if you go back to Grafana and refresh, you'll see the root span ID as well as the child span ID for the database request. First, we'll test it locally and then we'll deploy it in Minikube. You can find the source code in my public GitHub repo. Now, let's go ahead and start. First of all, you'll want to clone my repo locally. By the way, all the commands that I run in the video can be found in the readme file. Alright, after you have cloned the repo, you'll want to change directory to lesson 178. Then you can open it in your favorite text editor. Mine is Visual Studio Code. Under that lesson, you'll find 3 folders, and we'll go over each file when it's time. First of all, let's take a look at the Golang application. I tried to use as little boilerplate code as possible and placed all the functions in a single file. It's just easier to follow and reproduce. At the top, we have a lot of imports from the OpenTelemetry project. Now, we need to declare a tracer variable that will be used to initialize and create trace and span IDs. Also, we need to declare a variable for the OTLP receiver endpoint. In our case, we'll send all the traces to the Grafana Tempo instance. Since we'll start developing locally and then deploy this application to Kubernetes, the best way to dynamically set this endpoint is using environment variable. We can do it in the init function and also exit if the variable is not set. Next, let's take a look at all available exporters from OpenTelemetry. In the official documentation, you can find only a few of them, such as console, which is primarily used for debugging and local development. Then we have OTLP exporter. We can send metrics using HTTP or gRPC endpoints, and there are also some other exporters available out of the box. It's not all. You can also find community-built exporters, such as Loki exporter and many others. Alright, let's go back to the code. First, declare a console exporter that will simply print the span IDs to the standard output. Secondly, let's declare another exporter that will send traces to any OTLP-compatible receiver. In our case, it's going to be Grafana Tempo. Since we deploy it in Kubernetes, we want to disable HTTPS and use plain HTTP. In Kubernetes, you can achieve mutual TLS using a service mesh, such as Istio or Linkerd. So this setting will remain disabled even in production, of course, if it's deployed in the same Kubernetes cluster. The second parameter is to set endpoint, which we'll get from the environment variable. The default is localhost 4318 for the HTTP and 4317 for the gRPC endpoint. First, we'll test this application using the console exporter and then move to OTLP exporter. Next is a bit of boilerplate code. We have a function to create a new tracer and we can also give it a name, for example, my app. In the main function, we'll create a context and initialize the exporter. For now, I'll keep OTLP exporter as the primary one. For this test, we'll use Qi REST framework to create a simple REST API. Additionally, we'll define a single slash devices endpoint to test the tracing integration and start the server on port 8080. Now, let's create a handler for the devices endpoint. First, we need to create a root span ID and give it a name, for example, HTTP get devices. This HTTP handler will run every time we access devices endpoint. Next, we have a DB function to simulate requests to the database. You can see at the bottom we pass context and use it to create a new child span ID, which uses the previous span ID as a parent. To establish this relationship, we simply need to pass a context with the existing span ID. In the database call, we simulate a 2-second delay and also add 1-second artificial delay to the HTTP request itself. This is the bare minimum you need to create trace and span IDs in the Go code. For the testing purposes, let's uncomment the console exporter. We'll use it first to test it locally, and then we'll test it with Tempo and Grafana. go back to the terminal, change the directory to my app, and download all the modules our app uses by running go mod tidy. Next, let's try to run it. You'll get an error indicating that we need to set environment variable. Let's do that now. We'll set it to localhost. Let's run it again. In another terminal, let's use curl to hit the device's endpoint. Alright, it works. If you go back to the previous terminal, you'll see two logs. The first one is the child span object, and the second one is the root span. Let me copy and paste it to a file to make it more readable. Now, you can see the name, trace, and span ID. You can see that the parent is all zeros, indicating that it is a root span object. There are also timestamps that will be used to calculate the latency for the requests, which you can view in Grafana later. By the way, in the Go code, you can add additional attributes to this object. Now, let me copy the second object. Here you can see the parent span ID that points to the previous span object, and these two objects have the same trace ID. Alright, let me switch back to the OTLP exporter. The primary focus of this tutorial is how to integrate Golang tracing in Kubernetes environment. For local development, I suggest you use Minikube. First, you'll need to install it, then run Minikube start. Optionally, it can use Docker to create Kubernetes nodes. To create reproducible environments, even if you're testing something locally, Terraform is the way to go. If you don't want to use it, I'll show you manual commands to reproduce this setup, but consider installing Terraform. First, we need to initialize Helm and optionally kubectl providers. Next, we'll install Grafana Tempo using Helm. If you don't want to use Terraform, I have included commands at the top that do exactly the same thing. In this case, we'll install Tempo Helm chart in the monitoring namespace and override some default variables. The next step involves a similar setup to deploy Grafana to Kubernetes. To override default Helm values, we need to create a couple of YAML files for each Helm release. This one is for Tempo, and it's mainly for running tests or a POC locally. And the second one is for Grafana. Here we hardcode the username and the password. The password for Grafana is devops123. That's all. Let's switch to the Terraform directory. Run Terraform init to download all the providers and initialize the local state. Then run Terraform apply to deploy the Helm charts. Verify that both pods are healthy and running. Next, get the services. You'll notice that Tempo has many ports open. For example, port 3100 is used by Grafana to query logs. You'll use this endpoint to create Grafana data source. We also have port 4318, which is HTTP receiver endpoint for the OTLP protocol. Additionally, there is another endpoint for OTLP, port 4317, which uses gRPC. To test it locally, let's port forward port 4318 to localhost. Also, in the same window, I'll port forward Grafana as well. We still need to set environment variable. Let's run the app again. Now, if we access the device's endpoint again, we won't see logs in the terminal with span objects. Those objects are sent to the Tempo instance in Kubernetes. Let's go ahead and check it in Grafana if you have traces. The username is admin and the password is devops123. First of all, we need to add Tempo as a Grafana data source. In a new Grafana, data sources are located under connections. Important note here, you need to add Tempo URL from the inside Kubernetes. The format is the service name followed by the monitoring namespace. Also, remember to use port number 3100. Once that's set up, you can go to Grafana Explorer tab and query traces. It appears to work correctly, and you can see both the root and child span IDs in Grafana. For instance, it took 3 seconds for the entire request, with 2 seconds spent on the database request. Finally, I want to show you how to deploy this app to the same Minikube cluster. For now, you can stop everything except Grafana. For deployment, we need a deployment object. I have already created a multi-arch Docker image using a build script. This script builds a Docker image for both AMD and IRM architectures and creates a single manifest like this. This image is public, so you can either use it for testing or build your own. It's a standard deployment, but in this case, we set the environment variable to endpoint inside Kubernetes. Secondly, we have a service. However, you can test without one. Alright, let's apply it. Wait a few seconds until the app is running in Minikube. Then port forward my app to localhost. Use curl again to access the application running in Kubernetes. Shortly after, you'll see a new trace ID in Grafana. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.